Hello, everyone, and welcome to our second episode of Game Worn 101 here at Heroes of the Crease Goaltending Museum and Memorabilia Limited, your number one goaltending museum project in the whole world. Before we get started, don't forget to click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and click the notification icon to get our latest videos as they come online. As we seek to preserve the history of NHL goaltending through its various game-worn relics, this series is all about identifying the unique types of wear and tear seen on game-worn memorabilia, with a particular focus on jerseys. Whether you are just getting into collecting, or if you are a seasoned collector yourself, these terms and types of wear are important to keep in mind. Today's episode will focus on paint and post-paint transfer. Now, the first question we have to ask ourselves is, what does paint transfer mean? No, paint transfer doesn't mean you were painting the ceiling in your living room and you happened to use a game-worn jersey as a drop cloth and got some drippage on it, but rather, it is most commonly the transfer of paint from either the goalposts or the ice level paint. The most common color for paint transfer is red, however blue paint transfers do exist. For the purposes of the video, we'll focus in on paint transfer from the posts. Why doesn't it get washed out? Why post paint survives through washing and into the secondary market, then last decades later without fading, is due to the types of paint that is powder coated onto goal posts. Why and how does it happen? To stop a puck from going into the net, a goalie must have their angles down perfectly. To do so, they must often hug the post or crossbar to prevent a shot from squeezing through. Sometimes their quick lateral movements result in a more pronounced impact with the pipes. Due to these factors, the red paint from the net sometimes has a tendency to rub off on a goalie's sweater, producing a distinct red mark, most commonly seen on the rear of the sweater or on its sleeves. Hugging a post which may already have damage on it from impacts can more easily transfer paint, as can chafing and rubbing of the jersey along the post throughout the course of a game. Additionally, if paint was recently applied to the posts, it can transfer onto jerseys a lot easier. To illustrate what this looks like on a game-worn piece of memorabilia, we will have three examples of game-worn jerseys with such wear to show you. The first is a 2011-12 Richard Bachman game-worn Dallas Stars jersey that he used for his first NHL win, among others. On the rear of the jersey, between the numbers 3 and 1, is a minor bit of horizontal crossbar paint transfer, as the goalie either leaned back onto the crossbar, or he was hunched over beneath it, allowing that part of the jersey to rub the bar. There's also some light post-paint transfer on the sleeve. The second example is a 2007-2008 Cristobal Huet game-worn Washington Capitals jersey that he wore near the end of the season and into that season's playoffs. As you can see, the right sleeve demonstrates a lot of heavy red paint transfer as a result of the same side post rubbing up against it. The final example for today is a 1984-85 to 1985-86 Kelly Rudy game-worn New York Islanders jersey that he utilized in many games, most notably his NHL playoff debut. The nameplate was removed and reused for his next jersey. That type of wear is a story for another episode. As you can see, the post-paint transferred onto the rear numbers, leaving distinct red stains, most notably on the number 3. I hope you enjoyed this simple video briefly explaining what post-paint transfer is. If you have any questions about the content, please don't hesitate to ask. If you're a new collector, I hope you learned something valuable today and had some fun. And if you're an experienced collector, I hope you enjoyed the video all the same. Until next time, my friends, have yourselves an excellent day. Bye-bye.